My question to you is, what is SOTIF? Why do we need SOTIF? And what is the standard? What is the status of SOTIF? And how will we apply that in our automotive safety landscape?
Maybe I start with a bit overview of what is safety then.
Safety. Absolutely, yes.
Safety, of course. You need to be aware that we have hazards, and hazards in automotive industry is clear to everyone. And you need to take care of all processes and subjects, equipment, combination that could do harm to people, injure people, or even kill people. So what's to be done in that? We have this functional safety, and functional safety deals with keeping people from being injured by some faults occurring in electronics or in software. This is one part. The second part is now, if there are not real faults, let's say, for example, random faults or standard faults in software. So if there are not faults, but something happens in the cars due to the environment, due to something that happens out of the scope of the car itself. And due to this occurrence out of the car, could happen that an accident will be caused. So this is then called SOTIF. And the next thing is, we have this case of some accident happening caused by failures or caused by some misinterpretation by the sensors of the environment, then this should all be covered by functional safety and SOTIF. But now there could be some people outside of this world acting on the whole system and bringing faults and failures into the system by intention. And this could be done by hardware, or it could be done by some other communication and bringing failures into this communication. And this is now a case of security.